you. We praise you for this day. But this is the day that you have made. And we shall rejoice and be glad. God, we give you praise this morning. We give you all in this morning. God, we magnify you.
Thank you.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter to his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him.
Thank you.
And we want
want to give her her flowers. Amen. Not only that she can see them, she can smell them. All right. And see the aroma that's coming from them, from the women and the men there at the Lily of the Valley. Those are the announcements. I think I've got them all. Govern yourselves accordingly.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. We're going to get ready to relinquish my stand. I'm going to relinquish my stand. Everybody's been moment to stand at this time. As we do another than our pastor, another than pastor, we're going to take the last statement we make this time.
A soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier.
Yeah.
heart of God our salvation to the Son of Jesus. Our Father, sure, we said before you had saved, sanctified, baptized, filled with God's Holy Ghost. Goes. Now, I can't sing and I can't do a lot of things, but I got good ears and I want somebody to listen to this mic and say amen. Amen. Too much trouble in there. Let me take about 36 to be a pastorate. Amen. Everybody can't cook chicken. Say amen somebody. Everybody can't bake cakes. You got some folk that can fry good chicken, but you tell them to make a cake, you're going to find eggshells and all kinds of stuff up in there. So leave the sound alone if you don't know how to do the deal with it, amen? Amen. Is that all right? Come on, let's give God praise. Hey, listen, I don't get to you right here. I don't hear the name of my life. I'll get saved and sanctified and baptized and filled with God for some of you. So certainly to all of the preachers, missionaries, mother, sex, and friends, let's not mind us again in that order. Amen. That's something I need for our own first lady, Mr. Christian. Thank God for her. Amen. I would love when I was checking her out and she all sharp and everything. And I just like nice. I like people to look nice. I ain't no wrong with looking nice. Clothes. And especially if she belonged to me. She snuck them shoes in on me. I didn't know I remember seeing them before. Amen. But that's all right. Amen. I saw them. Amen. I remember seeing him say amen. She did it. Well, I thank God for being able to celebrate another year with my wife. I mean, if you ought to be able to have family, and I know I'll be happy. And, you know. So I thank God for my children. We went out and spent the night with her on Friday and spent most of the day with her on yesterday. Just amen. Help her as missionary works and give her father's wife. She's alive. Now, God's good enough. I want to just say this openly, too. We just want to thank God for our newly elected presiding bishop of the Church of God, Christ, Bishop J.G. Sheehan. And we want to support him and believe God and ask God to help him and encourage him. Whenever you lead over 6 million people, amen. That ain't easy. Say amen. Jesus had 12. Come on, somebody. He had 70. First, our 7 year old son, and all of them left him but 12, and one of them was a devil. Say amen. So we know that, amen. It's not easy. We want to pray and strength. Isn't that right? Amen. That God will speak to him and lead us into the right direction. And certainly we'd rather see sinners back there and suck up. Amen. They know where home is. Amen. Come on, amen. And then Dad Dupree is in the house again. We love that. Amen. Most of what you see, man, his handprints and Mother Dupree handprints is on this. Amen. But we thank God for them. Isn't that right? Amen. Now, some of y'all got the wrong memo. When I come in, they said, I don't know if he gonna be able to deal with them Dupree's over there, but me and the Dupree's are just fine. Say amen. Just being honest with you, amen. And I thank God for them. Now, listen, we're in the midst of supposed to start on our roof on the 20th of April, so pray for the weather. So we're there so we can get it done. Amen. 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 We got some other things that we're going to do. Amen. And amen. We're just going to paint the sanctuary because they touched up and you know, I know you can use mix and match. You understand the clothes, but when you mix and match and shine somewhere and flat somewhere, that bothers my faith. I'ma just tell y'all. Amen. So we hope that and do what we want to do. So you pray for us as we have endeavors to give a face, amen, to the sanctuary, to the church. Isn't that all right? Amen. And it also shows where your contributions go, however God gives, you know, whenever funds and stuff come in, I'm not one of those guys who look for a way or come up with a way, and they'll tell you, the trustee board, on how I can get a piece of the pie. Yes, and as a matter of fact, they have to make me almost. The same thing I started with 12 years ago is what I'm doing right now. So that shows you that I'm not greedy, amen, and I don't do that. And I think you all do right, but then I think that everything ought to be done according to the strength of the ministry. Say amen, somebody. Amen. That's why I go to work. Say amen. I ain't got time to try to help the church and live out of the church and all that stuff. Amen. My children, my wife need things. We, you know, I'm strong. I'm still pretty young. I can do some things I used to do. Well, I can do them. I just can't do them as well. Amen. But you see, and so I want the church to flourish. And I believe that the church flourishes, that I'll flourish, that you'll flourish. This is seed time. This is the spring. Come on. We're coming up on the spring. And in spring, the season of spring, things come forth. But there's a scripture in the Bible that says, and Isaac sold in the land in the same year. Watch this here. In that same year, he received 100-fold. But if you look at there, there's a colon in between that, and a comma, or a comma, and another dot, and another colon. And the next word says, and the Lord bless them. I've never had saw that before, even though I saw a lot of times. Watch the text. Come here. He said, Elijah sowed in the land, and in the same year, that's number one, he reaped 100-fold.
Yes, sir.
And then you have that pause, and on the other side of him receiving 100-fold, the Bible said, and the Lord bless him.
Yeah.
Now, when I read that before, I read it together, so I made, but that ain't what it's saying. The text is saying, he received 100-fold, and then the Lord blessed him.
Yes,
I ain't got no help around that. You got to get this. You understand what I'm saying? And so don't tighten up. You understand when it comes to doing what you're doing, and you all have been wonderful. I thank the faithful, whether they're here or not, whether we're in church or not. And we're going to be back in full session unless something happens soon. But since we got a couple projects that we are going to do, we'll probably leave it like it is for now. Amen. And then you ought to be glad. See, those of us that saved and sanctified, we glad to come to church.
Amen.
I got my 3 amen. Say amen. And it couldn't all go business. You see, if something happened, then I can't keep you out of the church. Yeah, when everything with the sun shining, y'all want to ride. Come on, somebody. Tell your neighbor, say, ride after service. Amen. But listen, I want you to be a part. What we're going to do, we're going to move expeditiously. We want to receive our tithes and offering. Then we're going to receive at this time, so we don't have to be late in time and service. So to bless our first lady, I still got to sow my seed. And see, that's how my wife and I are. We sow seeds to each other.
Amen.
You understand? I mean, I sow seed. As a matter of fact, whatever happened in the Lily Ella Valley, I'm a part of it. I don't just ask you to do something that I don't do myself.
Amen.
I'm not that type of guy. I need to be blessed too. Amen.
Amen.
All right, so I want y'all, everyone standing. If you're going to give, amen, when you give, brother, you can give if you do the social media way, Giveify, Lily Ella Valley, Church of God in Christ, 976 Charlotte Avenue. Also, Cash App, $ Lily Ella Valley, the numerical number 26. That's one word, $ Lily Ella Valley 26. And you can also be a P.O. Box, 64904, Rochester, New York, 14624. I've said this so much, you've done it for so long, you probably got it down pat and know it by heart. And then you can give also in the church. And if you do it, the Lord bless you. I gave my tithes this morning. Amen. I thank God I raised my children. My children tithe. Come on, somebody. Amen. But I'm telling you, man, it's a blessing. Amen. And I'm telling you, never be for your privilege if you're not a consistent tither. Don't let anybody tell you that's wrong.
Yes,
if you're not a consistent tither, you are never beneath your privilege. It can be your home, that's what you can name, your children. There's a lot of things that can hinder you. So I just want you to know that. Amen. All right, everyone is saying you can, all of those on my right that are giving it here, you can just put your, to my right hand, pass it down to your left. Those on my left side, you pass it down to your right. You can watch it till we get all the way down to the personal end that will receive it. Father, we thank you right now. We appreciate you. We glorify you. We ask that you look now upon these that are sowing their seed into good soil. This is spring, and things are getting ready to spring forth. And all of them that obey your word, God, tell them don't look for an open door, but thank God for an open heaven. In Jesus' name, thank God and amen. Come on, sow your seed, sow your seed. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. Hallelujah. Did we have some fun on this side? Oh, well. y'all keep going over there. Okay, then. Mess up my rhythm. Come on.
God, I asked God, what can I do? So I realized I have to sell some masks. So I was able to sell another message. We sent you from the hospital this morning. God bless you.
No amount of words or monetary gifts can amount to the service, the commitment, and the sacrifice you consistently do for your husband, kids, and church. But love is an actual word. So we want to show you our love and give you your flowers while you're alive and working ever so diligently. So with that being said, Missionary Thomas and I have something for you.
We would like to present you with this all-paid-for weekend extravaganza with you and your best friend, our pastor.
Oh, yes.
Happy birthday.
I'll be really, really short. I don't want to cry. But thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I love you all. I'm so appreciative. If I talk too much, I start crying. I'm a crybaby. But know, without a shadow of doubt, that I love the Lily of the Valley, Church of God in Christ. I didn't know how it would be when we came over here. It was a little hard for me because we had been over at the former church for quite a while. But I can truly say that I am happy. Yes. I am happy. I love you all. I love all of you from the bottom of my heart.
Amen.
Yeah, I know I like. Did somebody take a picture of the box?
Happening now, they're opening up because the economy has, amen, just been totally in a year has just been ravished and trashed, if you will, to for a stronger use of the word. And so when you look at big business, they understand that the only way that we can sustain or the economy can sustain itself, and you thank God, and many of you are thankful for what the new president has done in terms of the stimulus and all that. But you got to be wise with that, because they can't keep doing that. They're not going to keep doing that. And so you got to be wise with what you give and what you have, and you got to understand, you got to prepare. Amen. Because just like one storm come, another storm will come. Say amen. And the reason that Joseph now was able to keep the people of God intact for the 7 years of drought was because he prepared in the 7 years that was favorable. Come on, somebody. And so when things are going well, you get a little extra cheese, as they say. You understand? You got to be smart with it. Come on, somebody. So I know everybody, when you've been going through, amen, you want to have a little time of festivity, and that's fine. But like we tell our children, look, you know, y'all going out of town, and we go out of town, but when you come back, you want to have money too. You don't want just all your money. This is what we talked when it was coming up. You don't want to just have all your money for when you to go out of town, but when you come back, you want to be able to have livelihood. Isn't that right? Amen. And you have to be careful, because stress will cause us, you understand, to when there's a break, to want to stretch your wings. Come on, somebody. But what you got to remember is you got to be careful that you don't fly too far over the ocean, that you don't have enough strength to get back. You understand? So we understand that the time of the day that we're living in, it is a time that we've got to be wise, family. Somebody tell you, they would say, be wise.
Be wise.
You got to use your smarts in this hour. You understand? Because we're against an adversary that's going to and fro, walking up and down in the earth, seeking whom he may devour. Now that word devour means seeking whom he may swallow up whole. If it was the devil's, if the devil could have his way, he would totally destroy you. You understand? The only reason you're going through tests and trials is because God puts boundaries in front of him. God said, yeah, you can go so far, like he did in the case of Job. You can touch his body, but no one messing with his soul. His life is not in his hands, Lord. His life is not in your hands, praise God. You understand? To do what you will. But you can come against his body. And let me tell you something, the way the devil is coming against your body is not just in sickness. He's messing with folks' emotions now. Can I talk? He's messing with your thought process. He's messing with how you think. You understand what I'm saying? And one of the things that the enemy is doing to every believer, you understand, he's trying to kill your joy. I got to hear that. The devil wants to sink your joy. You understand what I'm saying? That's why you have some people, their bills are paid, but they don't feel good. They feel like something is missing. Some of them, amen, they're married now. They have their spouse, they have their husband and their wife, but they still don't feel complete. And what it is, it's the enemy that's trying to sift you. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Come on, come on. And I'm sorry, y'all, but y'all sit around and talk about what she did me wrong. And I don't ever want another woman. She did me, he did me wrong. And I don't ever want another man. I'm just going to be by myself the rest of your life. That's crazy. Say amen. Look at somebody say crazy, crazy, crazy. Why do you want to be by yourself the rest of your life? Because you had a bad experience with one person. And if you're not careful, that type of mindset will flow over into your walk with God. I ain't got no help here. But I hope, first lady, don't ever leave me. I'm with her to the end. I told her the other day, Jeanette, I will love you until the end, E-N-D, forever. And y'all tell me when that stopped at. I ain't got no help around here. I hope that, but if she leave me, I may be blind, crippled, and crazy from 8 to 80. But I'm gonna try to fight. Y'all ain't talking around here. Because she didn't tell me. I had to be young and say nothing. You can't make folk love you who don't want to be with you. All you're going to do is injure yourself. Come on, somebody. So you got to be comfortable. You got to be comfortable. You got to be wise in this hour that you don't let anybody run. Or let me say it like this. Tell your neighbor, say, don't let the devil rain on your party. Say amen. You see, you got to understand. I tell people my powers, my water. I tell people, now let me tell you something. When you invite somebody to party, it is wrong for you to go there and tell them, I don't like pink and blue. They should have had 3 candles and not 23. Say amen. It ain't your party, say amen. It ain't your party. You're going there to celebrate the one that's being celebrated. Come on, somebody. And so you should refrain your judgment and keep that to yourself. You understand? It's enough going on. There is a depression in the air. Y'all ain't saying nothing. In the air, praise God. We feel the depression. You got food. Your bills are paid. You know where your children are. But you feel disconnected. Say amen. This is why you have to be careful. And we've got to go on to try to be, you know, saved and sanctified. Because when we ate of the tree of knowledge of evil and good, we separated ourselves from God. And this is why Jesus had to come on the scene, because there was no man on the earth, you understand, that could redeem us back into a right relationship with God. And so God's son, he said, prepare a body for me and I'll go. I got no help here. He said, I'll go and I'll redeem mankind back. You understand? Because now, if we're going to have God see us, the Bible said that all of your righteousness is as filthy rags. And so when the devil sees us, stand up, stand right there. Stand right here. And so when God looks at me, he don't want to see me. You understand? He don't want to see me. He wants to see a reflection of himself. Yeah. Come on, somebody. Yeah. In me. Yeah. The only way he can see a reflection, because all of our righteousness is as filthy rag that he had. You understand? And so when God look at me and I'm saying, he see flesh.
Yeah.
I ain't got no help around here.
Amen.
He see flesh. Yeah. I know I'm praying. I know I'm saying thank you, Jesus. But he sees the flesh. Watch this here. And this is God. God is looking, but he sees the flesh. This is what happened. Jesus comes on the scene now and gets in front of me or in me. And now we turn around and face God. Turn around and face God. Let me go back this way. You get in front of me. Turn around and face. So now when God sees me, you understand? He don't see me first. He sees the blood first. No, they said nothing. Of the crucified lamb. Because when Jesus shed his blood paid the price. The Bible says he became the propitiation. He became the debt satisfier. He paid the ransom. Y'all ain't saying nothing. He paid the ransom. Come on, somebody. And so when he looks at me, the only way I got a chance is because I go through Jesus. And so for everybody else, you think you can get through it any other kind of way? The Bible said, Jesus said, without the shedding of blood, there could be no remission of sin. So even though I'm confessing with my mouth and I'm believing in my heart, it only goes so far. But when I confess with my mouth and I believe in my heart, and watch this, mother, when I say these words, in the name of Jesus, Jesus steps in. God looks at Jesus, and when he looks through the blood, I become clean. I ain't got no help around here. Somebody give my Holy Spirit. And this is how, and this is why you got to be careful to keep him in your life. Let me help you. 2 Timothy chapter number 1. 2 Timothy chapter number 1. Get your Bibles, let's stand to our feet. I say that because if we stand in here, we won't have to stand, come on somebody, in the courthouse. scepter. Second Timothy chapter number one. Beginning of verse 5. When you have it, shall I have it? Second Timothy 1 verse 5. Very familiar passage of scripture. When I call to remembrance the unfringed faith that is in thee, which dwelt in first in thy grandmother. Hallelujah. I thank God for my grandparents. I thank God for my mother, Donna Green. You know her, she's married to John Green, and he went to Church of God by faith. And when she had gotten in Church of God in Christ, she said, well, I went with my husband. You understand? She said, but I took Koji with me. Say amen.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
And then I thank God for Mother Lola Crystal.
Yes, thank you.
And I don't know. There was so many by faith folk over there at 131 Butler Street. You understand? We were just wanting to say amen somebody. He said, when I call to remembrance the unfringed faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois and thy mother Eunice, I am persuaded that in thee also. Watch it. Wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gift of God, which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. For God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, and of love, and of a sound mind. Let's read verse 7 together on the count of 3. Let's read it in concert. 1, 2, 3. For God. Again. Then he said, I want me to go back to verse 6. Wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou stirred the gift of God, which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. Father, in Jesus' name I pray. These people see you not me. Let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength, my redeemer, happening behind the cross. Speak to these lips of clay. Let no flesh glorify. Be glorified that my name may be magnified in the earth. I become a child of baptism, decrease that I might increase through me. Let this word fall in order, ears to hear, open heart to receive. And God bind the devil today. Cast him out of our mind in the name of Jesus. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. In this hour,
in this season,
I don't care what you're going through, no matter how dry it gets. Look at your neighbor and say, fan your flame. Keep your seat. You got to learn to fan your flame, because there's a lot of flame killers in church. There's a lot of things that will cause your flame of fire. That fire being in the natural and spiritual, a desire, if you will, something in you that spark in you that keeps you going. That even in the midst of it, you understand, because that fire is in you, your constitution to live is strong. Some people live because they have a strong constitution to live. You understand? Death is at their door, but yet they have this constitution about living that they're willing to endure the pain. And you've got to be careful in this hour, because everybody can faint in their mind. And Deacon Rick or Deacon White, y'all might want to turn the heat down, because it looks like some of these sisters going to faint in here. Amen, somebody. When I see the sister standing, I know it's got to be hot. Yes, amen. I don't see what else it could be, but I'm just saying, woo! Amen. Hallelujah. You have to be careful in the hour that we live in, because as we continue our walk, we must understand, in order for you to be effective in this day and time, we as saints must be forced through the testing and trials of this life. Did you know what I'm saying? That's what the Bible said. Thinking, beloved, thinking not strange concerning the fiery trials which come to try you, as though some strange thing had happened. And then he tells you something very strange. He says to rejoice and be exceeding glad. He wants us to get happy about going through. I ain't got no help. I heard a lot of stuff that didn't sound right, but that don't sound right. But God wants us to rejoice when we going through. Because when you praise God as a believer in the midst of going through, what you don't see, but what's really happening, you're keeping your fire ignited. I got no help around here. See, you don't understand what type of child of God you will be. Come on, somebody. If your flame for God, your passion for God, your passion to praise God, your passion to lift your head, you don't understand what type of child of God you would be if that flame is ever extinguished. I ain't got no help here. And so it's through the test and trial, it's through the trouble, amen, that we learn, and call somebody, we learn, amen, how to go through. But in the midst of our being made, we must learn the valuable lessons that comes with the sincerity of your walk. And see, that's why I ain't got time to be playing. I ain't got time to be like some of these people, they play and they feel like it's gonna be all right. I ain't got time to be acting like to get into the tortoise and the hare syndrome, where the hare understands that I've got the speed, and at any time I can make it to the finish line. I can run circles around the turtle. Because that means that you won't, that you're not gonna do due diligence. And so even when I'm tired, I still get up and make room and make time to read my scripture. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I'm tired, I'm running late, I got up late, but I got to defeat the devil, because if he can give me not to read the name next to tomorrow, he can give me the, y'all ain't saying nothing. And all of these things, come on here now, are the enemy, praise God, trying to put your flame out. You have to, the Bible said that he made his ministers a flame in fire. And if you will be the fire of the flame of God, you will be like, come on somebody, you'll be like the devil, say man, that has artificial light. The Bible says that the devil comes as an angel of light. Meaning he'll dress the part, he'll talk the part. He know how to clap like us, and he know how to dance like us. He know how to speak in some type of unknown tongue, but he don't have no power. And I'm going to tell you that when you find the saint of God, when you find a child of God that's got fire, you understand what I'm saying here? There's fire in your praise, fire in your hand clap, fire in your dance. I need to tell you that you got power. I just want somebody to ball your fist up and shout with my power. Yeah, we gonna get there. I was kind of light. I said, ball them up and shout with my power. I feel it coming in the house. I don't have time to take shortcuts. I understand, you understand, if I don't do it the way God says do it, I'm gonna have to go back and do my first work over. And that's where the devil is trying to get me, but he keep on sending us back because of our inconsistency with God, and because God has to be faithful to his word. When God said that, when God puts a course that you and I must follow, and we deviate from the course, eventually we have to go back and do the first work over. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. And many of you, you spend all of your time going back to the beginning, say amen, because you don't know how to stand or withstand in the evil day. The church is about growth. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You want to put your time in and become better in your business, you'll stay up all night. You don't try to find ways to make your business better. You want to put all your time in your athleticism. You understand? So if you're an athlete, you'll spend all your time practicing. You want to spend more time in your studies. You'll spend all of your time getting information. Call somebody that can help you be more skilled in your studies. But when it comes to God, you'll work all day and go to sleep without praying. When it comes to God, you'll go 2 or 3 days. You understand? When I ever tell the Lord, thank you. And you will not the devil to reduce us down until the only time we're going to praise God, the only time we're going to have a fervent prayer is says, verse 6, he says, wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou stir, agitate, shake things up. Because see, it's easy to get complacent and lackadaisical. Oh, come on, somebody. It's easy to get caught up in the norm of church. See, that means God ain't there. See, why are people talking about, you know, I'm just sick of church norm? See, that means God ain't at that service. Because you can have the same program, but when God come in, it'll never be the same service. You can preach a message, you understand? I used to get all messed up as a preacher, because I'm talking about, I'm preaching the same message. I know I'm studying, but he ain't giving me nothing. And I'm preaching the same message. And then I hear folks, you know, look how the devil will do. And preachers that will come and preach, and he says, if you preach the same message over and over, that means you ain't studying, God ain't used you. Now, they weren't even talking about me, but I took it like they were. Because I felt like, well, God, and then I found out, wait a minute, the Lord woke me up. Tell your neighbor, thank God for the Lord. The most repetitious book on earth is this.
That's right.
This book has been saying the same thing over and over since its inception. Come on, it's about getting, see, that's the problem with the church. The church wants to move to the letter Z when they ain't even graduated from the letter A. Say amen, somebody. Hallelujah. If God got you teaching on love for 20 months, it's because there ain't enough love in the sanctuary. Y'all ain't talking about it. I used to wonder why God would say what he would say. And sometimes it wasn't even in my notes. Because he said that if you will be my disciple, you will go where I tell you to go, do what I tell you to do, and catch this, say what I tell you to say. Stir up! Stir up the gift. I know you're shouting, but your shouting got dull now. Your shout got cobwebs on it. Your tongues is the same now. And you know me, now, I don't believe that you in a sanctified church and you got a whole section on here and all y'all dancing the same way. Everybody over there dancing. Everybody in the section. No, no, no. God don't move like that. When the Holy Ghost get on the inside and start working on the outside, it may have one person jumping, another person rocking to the side, another person running another person cried because God moves differently. Oh, y'all know them the same old stuff. I'm seeing that stuff. And I'm fighting against it.
Yeah.
Listen, let me give y'all this sidebar. For all these new tech, these new prophets that give you what you want to hear. Now, come here now. I can't be real to you, Tom. Let's talk. The Lord gives a word.
Amen.
He loves you.
Amen.
That's number one. He said, I don't want that any should be lost, but that everybody should come to repentance and get in that place with God where they can be ready. You remember he said in John, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in me, believe also in my Father. And in my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I'm going to prepare a room for you, that where I am, you may be also. You understand? And one word for that, those rooms, is many mansions. He said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. You understand what I'm saying? So now, God, here, you living right. You going through. I'm coming in town as a prophet. You live in foul as all our doors. You don't get a word. Yea, I see thee. And in 2 days, you're going to be a millionaire. I see you with houses all over the country, and you just a whoop, whoop, whoop. And then you get on the phone and tell somebody, hey, y'all. There's a prophet in town. Let me. He told me something nobody knows. You right. Because it wasn't God. That's what nobody can know. The Bible said it brought something over. Let me say some prophecies for the future. But there's no way God's going to see
you in sin, practicing sin. You understand the Bible said Ecclesiastes 8:11, because the sentence of this evil work is not executed speedily, it is in the hearts of the sons of men to do evil. Don't say nothing. But he said, though his punishment be prolonged, it is better for the righteous to stay sane than for those who are ever kept cause. God loves you so much that he ain't gonna send you no word. Talk about you for me blessed in the north, the east, and the west. If you can see it, the first word God gonna tell you is to get your life right. I got no way around. And they made a living with telling us untruth. They made a living. And then they get all faith of who we have service. Then y'all don't have service. Y'all have stimulation. If I find the right spot and I stimulate you, it's going to make me or make you react a certain way. Whatever way the stimulation is, it's going to make you react a certain way. And we don't know the difference between stimulation or stimulation in the Word. We need the Word of God. We need real, we need agape love, not eros. Eros is a love, but it's erotic. It's sensual and it's close to sexual. We don't need that kind of love. Say amen. You need this agape love, this godly love. Hallelujah. You need this love that keep your fire ignited. And I want to tell you, when the devil come at you and trying to soothe you down and mess you up, all he's trying to do is put your flame out. But you got to have a fire down on the inside that's start burning on the outside. I wish I had somebody say, fan your flame, fan your flame. You got to learn the valuable lessons that comes with the sincerity of your walk, and learn how to fervently pray through without losing hope. You have to understand that your adversary, the devil, will continue to mount an attack against you and those you love. Because if he can discourage you, he knows he has you. Most of us don't lose in the middle of our test. We lose in the turn of our test. Most of us lose on the way out of the test. If you have been faithful, you've been standing, you've gone through everything since you've been in the test, and now that God is turning you and you're on your way out, then you start practicing what you have been practicing, and you start losing, come on somebody, you start losing your desire to wait on the Lord, losing your desire to trust in the Lord. And when this happens, hallelujah, the devil starts creeping back in with all types of urges and thoughts and proclivities and strange desires. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Now you want to cut corners. I ain't got no help around here. You don't want to crucify the flesh no more. You want to comfort the flesh. But if you ever want real power, you got to crucify this flesh. Because the scripture says that there's no good thing that dwells in the flesh, that the flesh and the spirit are an enmity against one against the other. They have nothing in common. That's why the Bible said put a difference between clean and unclean, and between holy and unholy. And that's why I can't get with this new church. I'm cut from the old cloth, because this new church lets you, you got too many liberties. You can do what you want and act like you want and dress like you want. When you don't understand acting like you want and dressing in your kind of way, then it's a suggestion. Are you listening to me? When I listen to music, if I'm not careful and I'm listening to the wrong music, my hands will subconsciously begin to rock to the beat. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And that's just like that snake that they blow the trumpet, and it comes up out the basket, and it starts moving. And I thought the snake was moving to the music. It wasn't moving to the music. It's moving to the vibration, because the snake is blowing the horn, but the God is blowing the snake that's blowing the horn. The God is blowing the horn that's got the snake moving. He's tapping the side of the basket, and it is the stimulation of the tapping of the basket that's making the snake be hypnotized and move. And if you're not careful, you'll let good looks stimulate manipulate you and mess you up. If you're not careful, you let the fact that you're not married and your sister got married make you do something crazy. And that's why you got to fan your flame. Because one thing the devil can't stay around, and that's the fire of God. The Ohio Players had a song called Fire. And I had an uncle, amen. He's going on to be with the Lord. You remember 8-track tapes? The whole 8-track tape, back to back, was fire. And so one day he lived on Lewis Street with us. And behind his house, there was some buildings, some old warehouses. And rumors began to come. Come on, somebody. From over there to the property. And my uncle had called the city and made complaints. And my uncle was an interior and exterior decorator, but he loved to get high. And so he'd be smoking weed and drinking vodka and taking pills. And he'd say, if you, I told him to do something about these rumors coming to my house. And so about a month later, they told me my uncle got high one night and pulled his van into his driveway and played and turned that 8-track on with fire on it and blasted and set that whole building on fire over there. And you know what happened? All the rumors began to run everywhere. And that's what I want to tell you. The only way you're going to keep certain things away from you as a child of God, you got to have the fire of God burning. Hallelujah. Burning when you're up, burning when you're asleep, burning when you're going through, burning when everything is all right. Because if you don't, all kinds of thoughts will parade you. You might not only talk, but you'll start doing some stuff that you ain't never did before. The Bible says that when an evil spirit go out of a man, it looks for a place to go. But as it walks in dry places, it cannot find a place to go. The Bible says that the evil spirit goes back to the house that he left. When he comes back to the house is in order. The house is clean. But watch it, the house is empty. So the Bible says that the evil spirit goes back out and goes and get 8 other demons. And that's worse than he is. And then he comes back and takes the house over. And the Bible says that the latter state of that individual is worse. That's why when you backslide, you used to drink, but you drink 3 times as much. When you backslide, you used to get high, but now you take all kinds of stuff. When you backslide, you used to have a sex problem, but now you're sleeping with any and everything. You know why? Because there's a devil that went out, and when it got some more devils that walked in. But if you ever had the fire, that's why I say I'm saved, I'm sanctified. Tell your neighbor, fan your flame. Give me a few more moments. Y'all sit down. This stuff is real. Look at your neighbor and say, it's real. Tell them spirits are real. Say the spirit of God is real. And the spirit of the devil is real. In this epistle,
come on, sir,
to his young protege, his spiritual son, and he gives him directions concerning the pastorate and dealing with the church, what he's going to have to encounter. And he said, I want to remind you what's in you, boy, and how it got there. Now we got to be careful, because he said, by the putting on of my head. See, everybody should be able to lay hands on me. I'm going over here now because I'm about to get deep now. See, they taught us you don't sit up under everything. Some of y'all are church problems. Can I say like a moment? Some of y'all are church homes. Come on, sir.
It's the truth.
I don't know how to like that.
It's the truth.
But a whole somebody that sleep with everybody. Say amen. And when you go and sit up under this ministry, that ministry. Now, I understand if you are between churches and you pray. Let me put that in a But I'm talking about people who just every time you see them, they just over here, over there. Come on, somebody. You sleeping with the enemy. Or you sleeping with enemies. Y'all ain't saying this never here.
Yes,
and what's what some of y'all have done in your life, like me, you need to be up under strong leadership. You need somebody to say just what I said.
Yes, sir.
I don't care if you, I was a clean drug addict. You was a dope fiend. Amen. I don't care if you was a Park Avenue or sleeping on a park bench. If you don't change, your name is going to be the same. I ain't got no help out here. Something in the church of God in Christ, in the holiness of the church of God, every Pentecostal church that I knew back in the day, they told us the truth. You had 12 babies, my baby, he ain't going to marry you. They told us that. They hurt your feelings, but they helped your soul. Come on, somebody. Amen. And the flame is out. He said, I'm about putting it on my hands. So I got to be careful, and you have to be careful. Because when I put my hands on you, I'm putting my heart on you.
Yes,
yes. You know what I'm saying? Because you allow yourself to be accessible to what's in me to get on you or in you. The devil is looking for to get on you and in you. God, too. But if I put my hands on you and I'm full of mess and you weak, then mess gonna get on you. That's why I tell the truth. I want you to carry myself. I'm nice to everybody. If I hug Sister Willis, when he ain't around, I'm gonna hug him in front of him. Because the first time you started doing that stuff, you entered into something. Y'all ain't saying nothing. See, my wife and I be like that. Yeah, amen. I hug every woman anyway, but there's some women that I hug. You know what I'm saying? I hug in front of my wife, in front of their husband, and they know that they hug each other. I got friends, praise God, that love my wife and sit there and talk to her. I be sitting around there trying to be around the corner, trying to look and pee. I go about my business, amen. Because I trust the God in my life, and I trust the God in your life. I got a friend in Buffalo, pastor. He said, do me in for Sunday, that anniversary. He said, what we do, renewing our vows. He said that he trusts me with his wife. Now you know that's saying something.
Yes, sir.
But it was the God in me. You understand what I'm saying? That's why I shake my hands. I ain't trying to hold your hands and talk about, oh Lord, and looking at you now, you know. Trying to hit, but sending subliminal messages. You understand? I ain't that type of pastor like that. I gotta be careful. You understand? Because I've been in a couple of ways, but I'm still suave. You know what I'm saying? But I have to be careful, say amen, that my good ain't evil spoken. Don't y'all, don't let this belly fool y'all, say amen. I know something, say amen. You understand? I like fragrances. My wife is beautiful. She dressed. She like fragrances. We go on places and people be talking about, they be like that puppy on Warner Brothers cartoon. Remember the one that be sleep? And the woman set the pie outside on the window ledge. Some of y'all too young to know that. And they show me the aroma and give the dog dog. He sleep. He don't even wake up. Just the aroma makes him levitate and fly, go right on over to the window so he can pie. Sometimes my wife, come on somebody, she passed by and she been gone 2 or 3 minutes and there's a trail. Come on somebody. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I'm trying to help y'all here. And that's why we carry ourselves a certain way. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Because we don't want, if a man come here with his wife or if a man or woman come here with her husband, we don't want them to feel like they gotta fear us because we ain't trying to be overly kind and over. We just nice people saying that. But I want you to know that after 27 years, next month on the 13th, it'll be 28 years, that if I can start all over and I can pick any woman I want, I still pick my wife. I got no help out there. So you ain't got to worry about that kind of stuff. Y'all don't like the son of teaching up in here. Don't y'all ever say, thank you, your flame. You gotta be careful who they hands on you. Don't be weak for no prophecy.
Yes,
because prophecy is based own lifestyle. You got to live it in order to get from God. And he said, I'm going to put you in remembrance that thou stir up, what's his name? Not your gift. He said, but the gift of God. I think I ought to about the gift of God. Come on, somebody. Now, if you're going to be anointed, you ain't going to be light. Preach what I'm telling you. So sometimes y'all come and you go, oh, I can look at y'all. I be like, well, it took good. You better put your big boy and big girl stuff on now. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Yeah, you ain't going to be light. It is all right. But see, you have to get through that season. Because I had a season that I was walking around with a chip on my shoulder. Like, I wasn't being mean to people. I'm not just that type, you know, you got to get my goat. You know what I'm saying? But I had it was an inward chip, and that's the worst kind. Because that thing would drag you down where you're going through the motions, but you ain't cool with that, you know. Because you know when you come in the room, they've been just, you know, or they got something to sidestep. And for me, it wasn't so much that I care about how you feel about me. You know, it was some of that streak that was in me that won't need to get out. I just want to go off on you, put you in your place, let you know you ain't nobody. I ain't thinking about you. I don't like you like that. I know how to play by myself. But that's not the godly way. And if you're not careful, you'll let this stuff shut up inside, and it'll become a monster within itself. You've got to learn how to keep your gifts stirred up, keep your oil stirred up, so that you can see him talking about you and keep on giving God the praise, honey, and keep on praying for him, and keep on saying, because the more you praise God, the more you look past him, the stronger you gonna be, the more they gonna shrink. And you know what's going to happen? Oh God, come over here. He's going to prepare a table for me from you in the presence of your enemies. Everybody counted you out, but God didn't want to make you count. That's why whenever you come to church, I dare you come here and don't give God praise. I dare you come here and don't celebrate God. You got to make it count. Oh, I got one witness in the house. Somebody throw your head back and holler, fire. I tell my family, I tell them, don't get on Facebook. To me, Facebook is not to share how your day been going. Because everybody's day has some kind of day, either a good day or a bad day. Facebook is time for publicity for me. I celebrate it. And the only reason I put my stuff up, you don't see me putting up my car. Well, y'all see me in the car. You don't know what kind I got. You don't know. But you don't see me doing that. But you'll see me doing stuff with my wife or my family.
Yeah.
Because that needs to be modeled.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? Yeah. A successful family. And I'm not just talking about money, because there's a lot of families got money and they have it. I'm talking about successful. I'm talking about a successful family where a husband and wife love each other. We together, that's my family. We disagree sometimes. We are, because I'm an alpha male. And every now and then I'm going to say no. Every now and then I just think I want to start an argument to make sure my skills still up. Amen. Because if your skills ain't up, them women will get you. Say amen. So you got to keep them argument skills up. No! I remember when me and Ella Simmons was on the phone, so I was talking to them. They always trying to show me how to do this technology and stuff, my daughter. And I tell her to go do it. I tell her to show me, she just go do it because she ain't got time. Dad, I just can't believe it. Why do you need this stuff? I'm like, oh my God. You know, we was doing it wasn't FaceTime. What was before FaceTime? The different ways that you could do the video? Skype and Uber. So we was doing that on the desktop, right? So I didn't know that the screen could go black, but you could see the camera could still be live when they can hear you or whatever. So first lady go holler down, because I'm telling you this after 20 some years, she still won't be around. I call my wife over 21 years, I call her every day on my lunch or break. And if I don't call, it's attitude. And I'm like, but the only problem I have with that is that when I call you, you talk about, I'm watching the news, can you call me back? The family Lord rebuke you. That's my spirit. I got mama on the phone, or this is good. I got Mother Rose on the phone. I almost got, Lord forgive me right now. Watch my mouth, I was so out. I can't take it. But so she wanted me to come upstairs, right? So I, and you know, she told my you coming to bed? I'm like, hey, I'm on here. I'm talking, you know, got my chest all poked out. So she was upstairs with school hopped up. You better come on up here and get in bed with me. Like, and so I get up there when I get ready while I'm walking up that way. And then out of nowhere, I hear this word to my pop, you better get on up and go to bed. And then he said this, man calling me too. So I do certain things so people can see us. You understand? As a family. As a strong family. You understand? Because that's what's getting ready to come back to the church. Family. And some of y'all gonna find y'all husbands and y'all wives right up in here. Come on, somebody. Hey, that's fine. I got to get out of here. It's time. Tell your neighbor and say, well, this is a good day to go get ice cream. Say amen. Amen. Tell them that's good. Yeah. Hallelujah. So you got to understand that your adversary, the devil, will continue to mount an attack against you because of those you love. If he can discourage you, he knows he has you. Most of us don't lose in the middle of our test. We lose in the turn, meaning at the point when we're on our way out, we often do crazy things. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Isaiah 43:2. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. And when thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned. Neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. Isaiah 43:15. I am the Lord your God, the creator of Israel, your king. Thus saith the Lord, which maketh a way in the sea, and a path in the mighty waters, which bringeth forth the chariot and horse, the army and the power. They shall lie down together. They shall not rise. They are extinct as tow. They are quenched as tow. Brother-in-law, I was sat on a mission. He said, I don't mind fire. You've got to get a fresh wig. Somebody shout fire. In the Hebrew, the same old word, fire, it denotes breath and wind, a spirit, amen, that's powerful. The effect thereof, and I need to tell you, don't let nobody discourage you to the point that your hands can't go up. Don't let nobody steal your joy. I don't care if you made a mistake. All have sinned and come short of the glory. And what people will do, family, I'm out of here. But darn, people will take your mess up. They'll take your mishaps. They'll take your shortcomings. They'll take it and wash it in your face. But I came by to tell you that you got to learn how to fan your flame. And I need to tell somebody here that everybody, you know, there's some of souls that every round goes higher and higher. And I need to tell somebody, because everybody got to go through something. And when you need your flame to go to another level, I got to tell you that God will blow on you. God will send a strong wind. But the wind of adversity is not to destroy you. It's to blow off the things that should not be on you. I got a witness here. Get up on your feet and have a proper cold. Let's fall down the tree. Touch your neighbor, say neighbor. Tell them the winds been blowing. Tell them the storms been raging. The winds are rolling. Their presence are passing. I know the way when I tell you that you got to have a fresh wind. And you need a fresh fire. There's one thing to come to church. There's one thing to do what you do. But it's another thing when the law flows on you. devil is a liar and a deceiver too. God is not through blessing you. God is not through blessing you. God is not through blessing you. That old devil is a liar and a deceiver. Lift your hands. God is not through blessing you. Mother, put your hands on that mother's shoulders right there. God is not through blessing you. That old devil is a liar and a blessing you. Somebody give God praise here. That old devil is a liar and a deceiver too. God is not through blessing you. That old devil, he's a liar and a deceiver too. will praise the Lord, but you've been letting the devil stop you from praising the Lord. You might as well go and praise the Lord. I couldn't. Listen, when I go to the hamburger joint, I go to eat a burger. Say amen. When I go to the bank, I go to put something in or get something out. Hallelujah. And when I come to church, I come to give God some praise. On the count of three, get on the house. And listen, lift in your lips. It ain't about how you feel. It's about the right time. On the count of three, give God a praise and watch what he do. One, two, three, praise.
Thank you.
I get in the Bible and I let the Bible get in me. Thank God that God read Mark Janelle that said if he'd even be going again, I'm coming to shoot him myself or something. Amen. No, I'm glad the Lord brought him back. That's my duty. You know, I love it. Listen, I want to tell you that the Lord loves you and that some exciting things are going to happen in your individual lives. And you're going to see some stuff beginning to come around in America. But don't be afraid of the news. I used to watch the news, but I watch the news. I watch the local news, I watch this, and I watch world news. You understand? I used to do that. And then when I was pastoring in Lackawanna, what the Lord told me, I used to, the first several months, maybe a year I was there, I don't know if some of y'all remember when I had everybody getting newspapers. Y'all remember that? Because I said, well, we couldn't touch the world individually, but if we got a world newspaper, when we pray, we can pray for the world. You understand? And so watch the news because you know what to pray against. See, the Bible said that they had a family called Issachar. And the Bible said they were the sons of Issachar because they understood the time. The way that you're not going to get trapped is to understand the time. You understand? When I was in the game, I understood what neighborhood I was in. When I was on the south side, I understood how they moved on the south side, and I moved that way. When I was on the north side, I understood how they moved. And all of my years, I've been in some Bible things before. I'm not giving the glory to that. But all my years, I never was in the game. And any city I ever went to, I was able to go all the time. I stayed on this side, 19 more. I stayed on Old Lewis Street when I first came here. And a dude sold me some bad dope. And I ain't going to tell y'all what I did. Amen. But, you know, I come from Michigan, so I learned how to move. Now that I'm saved and sanctified, I know how to go in and go out of any situation. When you're going to pray to somebody in the hospital, don't pray the same type of prayer that you pray on Saturday night prayer. Because you're going to be there for a while. You go there and pray and be gone. Lift your hands. Let's stand up before the Lord. Father, we thank you now for your goodness and mercy. Look on your people today. Whatever need that they have need of, meet every need today. Turn situations around. Rosalind Parnell, y'all know many of y'all, that's my cousin. The Lord, I was on the other night, about 3 weeks ago, and I was praying, and the Lord called her name out. And I said a word about one of my cousins to give to her. She looked for me for 3 weeks. I didn't know I accidentally blocked her by mistake. I didn't her number. Last night she came and showed me what the Lord did. First Lady Teresa Alexander just dropped in my spirit. Pray for her husband. You know what I'm saying? Pray for them. I'm telling you. And see, when I was doing that prayer, I had said that I wasn't going to prophesy, because I don't want people to come on there for that. But then God said something to me. He said, wait a minute now. If you're praying and something igniting you and I give you a word, how are you going to do that? And so God has had me pray for people in England. I don't know nobody in England. I don't know nobody in certain parts of the South. But they come back with a report. Say, man of God, every word God said through you was true. You understand? I don't have to know you, but God knows you. Hallelujah. God bless you. In the years, put this on you. It ain't poison. It's gonna clean your mind. Because what you can't get over is a lot of stuff in your past. And you can be having a good day and stuff, and then you think about something that ticked back there, and it messes you up. But God said, stop looking at it, even though some of all of it went good. But God said, look at it as a testimony that He brought you out of it, and you survived it, because you was not supposed to be here. You were supposed to die in that stuff. You understand what I'm saying? You've been in some situations with some individuals, and you were supposed to die. You were supposed to be dead. Your children were supposed to be motherless. Your mother was supposed to be daughterless. But the Lord brought you through. Hallelujah. And if the worst thing the devil can do is take you back to what he took you through, you look at the devil and tell him, you ain't taken me through it, but God brought me out of it. Come on. Come on, somebody. God brought me out of it. And every time you cry, you understand there's layers that's dropping off you. That's going to come off you. God's going to heal you in your emotions. You got to be healed in your emotions. And you got to be healed in your emotions. And yet you got to be healed in your emotions. Lift your hands. In your emotions. In your emotions, you got to be healed. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Push your hand, man. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. You've been through a lot. I don't know you. If I know you, I don't know. I know you. But you've been through a lot, and you're going through something right now. But God told me to tell you, just to reignite something in you, reinforce something about who He is, His sovereignty. When you walk in here today, I don't know who told you to come or how you got to be here, but when you walk in here today, God turned two things around for you. Hallelujah. Before this month is out, hallelujah. When is this month out? Huh? That's okay. Before this month is out, those two things are going to show up. Hallelujah. You went through something as a child, praise God. The enemy has been trying to use that against you to destroy you. But there's some people that's praying for you. No, they really praying for you. And I want to tell you, God is going to see you through. Father, in Jesus' name, from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet. Listen, you're not going to be able to fit. I'm trying to pray for you. You ain't going to be able to fit in with everybody. That's how when you get these certain little groups and stuff that don't work, you can pick them up. You see them. You see them for who they really are. You understand what I'm saying? And it makes you feel frustrated and alone, because frustration is disappointed expectations. And your expectations are about yourself. But what God's trying to do is not let you put your expectation in them, but in Him. Because He'll never fail you. Father, in Jesus' name, right now, for every hurt, for every betrayal, for every move that was against Him, that was shame, from the crown of his head, give him peace in his thoughts. Touch him, God. Clear out his thoughts. And then begin to speak to him and order his steps in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen. Come on, clap your hands. Let's go home. It's late. It's late. Father, we thank you. It's late. I ain't need to be on this earth. Y'all help, y'all stay. God bless you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Let's go home. But because you're a caretaker, because you have a heart that'll help, God said this prayer that you pray. He said, tell her I'm gonna answer it for her. He said, tell her I'm gonna answer. And you are sponge for the word. You looking for it. You go back and read over it because it brings a soundness about you. You understand? And when nothing else can comfort you, you always got your word and you got notes, hallelujah. But God said that word that you've been eating have been planted and it grew roots. And now that word is going to birth on the inside of you. And what the devil has been trying to deny you and stop, God says, get ready to come forth. Hallelujah. And there's some people, praise God, that's waiting to hear. They need to see your expression. You trying to change and be something else. But God made you like you are. He wants you to do it because of the people that he's sending you to follow in Jesus' name. It'll never be the same. It'll never be the same. It'll never be. Bring that down, sir. Stay right there. Bring it down, sir. I'm trying to go home. They're telling you you're too wild. You're too loud. They told me that. But what they don't understand is when you begin to praise God, when you begin to clap your hands, when you begin to get up and be like this here, that devil start trembling and sicknesses start being healed and y'all start being destroyed. Y'all ain't talking here. Somebody give God praise. You gotta praise the Lord. Say, fan your flame. They trying to put your fire out. They trying to kill your joy. Fan your flame.
Yeah.
dismissed, but I cover you. I cover you with the word of God and with the blood of Jesus. That your victories will keep you at night. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Fall back a little bit. Just, you trust your wife? Fall back. She got you. But I push you forward. Because he getting ready to come out of a comfort zone. And he getting ready to go 3 levels higher. Oh, I know you've been running from it, but now you're finna run into it. Hallelujah, your praise is going 3 levels higher. Hallelujah, go and praise him. I see more on the other side.
Amen.